Hey guys, Ralph here. Welcome to True Power Trumpet Fitness on Terrific Tuesday here in Connecticut. Life's good, man. Life's good. Yeah. You saw the thumbnail. Jerry and I are perfect examples. Perfect examples of what I was talking about yesterday. Got some comments and everything, and to the contrary, I want to explain myself. Okay? Anyway, yeah, I have played today, so I should be in good shape. Let me honk a few notes, and we'll talk about limits. None. Girls home. Couldn't be happier. Anyway, some of you watch the comment section, some of you don't. Trust me, at least 80% of the comments come on my email. Fine, no problem. Okay, with that said, I got a comment and I want to read it, and I have to refute it thus. Anyway, I remember watching a James Morrison interview when he said that everyone has physical limits when it comes to trumpet playing. He has specifically said that some players play higher than he does. Okay, I agree with one thing. Lots of guys play higher than he does. But I couldn't disagree more that the physical limits that anybody has does not have an issue with great chops, unless there are genetically predisposed to playing the trumpet, tongue issues or something like that, a regular, healthy, relatively healthy person, no, there are no limits. I disagree with him completely. From person to person and person, each one has a different limit? No, that couldn't be more wrong. That defies 100% anything done with physiology. Case closed. Now again, Jerry at the end of his life was too weak to play the trumpet. If something along those lines is part of your physiology, so be it, I'll give you that. But other than that, many, many physical deformities actually help. I've seen guys with enormous tongues to the point where they had to get them shaved down surgically so they could actually talk properly. That would be an enormous advantage in trumpet playing. Jerry and I had that issue with a player years ago, and that's a different video. Okay, maybe I'll do it tomorrow just to put a little recap on it. But guys, that's not the way this physiology works. Now, I understand if you're 5 feet tall, no, you have physical limitations. You can't play in the NBA. But in this case, every single one of us, unless it's a genetic problem, has the strength of the tongue to play extraordinary tone, power, range, and endurance. Now, as I said in the thumbnail, Jerry and I are the perfect examples. First of all, when Jerry was 40 years old, now think about that, 40 years old, and he'd been playing the trumpet since he was 10. When he was 40 years old, he could not play a high C. Okay, and I'm not talking, well, it wasn't very good, and at the end of the concert, you know, he had endurance, but no, he literally could not play a high C. He could not get out of the staff. He went to some of the greatest teachers that ever lived. William Vaciano, Nat Prager, Jimmy Smith, and ask them, why can't I play a C in the middle of the staff and slur it to an E on the top space without cracking every single time? They couldn't tell him. This was the chops that he had when he was 40. By the time he was 80, he was playing quadruple Cs. Don't tell me there are limits. And this guy is not some superhuman physical specimen. He's a short little rotund Jewish guy that couldn't run around a block if you put a gun to his head. No, this is, no. I disagree with you completely, sir. And I absolutely 100% disagree with James Morrison. Now, I would love to see that interview and see exactly what James Morrison said. I mean, I don't doubt for a minute that he said that, but it is physiologically incorrect. That's all. Now, I said Jerry and I. Guys, when I was 40, now, I had a better start than Jerry. When I was 40 years old, I could play a good G, F and G, okay? Working on double Cs. I could squeak some double Cs, but they weren't what we wanted, okay? When I was 18 years old and came to New York, I could play high C. Absolutely, my chops, of all the orchestral guys, my chops, naturally, before I even went to Jerry, Bach mouthpiece and all, were considered above average, okay? It wasn't Phil Smith, you know, at 18. It wasn't Herseth at 18, but it was the next best thing. I had good chops. But guys, there is no chance in the world that if you asked me when I was 20, 25 years old, that I would have these chops when I was pushing 70? No. Guys, and it's getting better. It's getting better. The only limits, I know this sounds like a Tony Robbins commercial. The only limits you're putting on yourself with the trumpet as far as tone, power, range, and endurance, the only limits you have are the limits you put on yourself. You can go as high as you want. You can play as loud as you want. You can have the most centered tone or the roundest tone. And you can play for as long as you want without getting tired. Tone, power, range, and endurance. No limits. Now, as I told you before, the only limitation I put on myself as far as the chops is that I just really don't feel like doing it. That's not why I get up in the morning. I'm retired. I've worked my whole life. I'm retired. This is, you know, and I, you know, getting a triple C is not necessarily my idea of a whole lot of fun. Give me up to the double C, play my Arban, play my excerpts, play my solos, make a video, write a book. That's what I want. Okay, that's the limitations I put on myself, but there are no questions in my mind that a triple C is there. And everybody can do it. I'm sorry. Everybody can do it. Now, if I saw the interview, I will agree if Jay Morrison said that there are limits on your innate musical ability, they can be developed to the max as well. But I could practice and I could study until I was blue in the face 24/7, and I would not have the genius ability of Miles Davis or Dizzy Gillespie or Vaciano, for that matter. I have better chops than all of them. That doesn't make me a better player. That I agree with. There are millions and millions of cello players in the history of whatever the instrument that put in countless hours studying. Slim. Are they ever going to be as Yo-Yo Ma, as good as Yo-Yo Ma? No. Some of them may. That came from God. That had nothing to do with work ethic. This is the ability to follow directions and a work ethic with right equipment. I agree, you can't do it on crap equipment. The world is yours, Chico. And everything in it. And I believe that completely. Anyway, I should be able to do something tomorrow. Thursday, absolutely not. Possibly Friday. But tomorrow might be the last one until Monday. Guys, if I don't see you, but I put up a video, have a great Thanksgiving. All of us in True Power Land. 2020's been a little crazy. And I know some of you musicians out of work and all that sort of stuff may... I think what I'm about to say is a little silly, considering your circumstance. But guys, we do have a lot to be thankful for. And, yeah. It's almost redundant as far as that's concerned. I count my blessings every day of my life. Guys, I've got double C's. Life's good. Eat and drink your fruits and vegetables and live your life with true power. Love you all.